Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the solution and discussion on the gate question paper in Mechanical Engineering subjects, Thermodynamics, Thermal Engineering, Heat and Mass Transfer, and Fluid Mechanics and Machines. And this is lecture number 23, so we are going to solve problems and questions in the Rankine cycle from various gate question papers. And before we get into the discussion, these are all the books I published earlier in mechanical engineering subjects: Design of Transmission System, Turbo Machines, Heat and Mass Transfer, Operations Research, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion, Thermal Engineering, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here and the solution for the gate question paper. It is absolutely free of cost. I request all the mechanic engineering students to subscribe the channel and use the video lectures for your better learning and to pass in the gate examination. The first question from 1991 question paper: in a Rankine cycle, heat is added. Four options are given: reversibly at constant volume, reversibly at constant temperature, reversibly at constant pressure and temperature, reversibly at constant pressure. And this is the Rankine cycle, simple Rankine cycle. So 1 to 2 isentropic expansion in the turbine, 2 to 3 the heat rejection in the condenser, 3 to 4 the compression in the pump, 4 to 1 is the heat addition. So the heat addition process here, it is constant pressure heat addition. So from 4 to 1 the pressure remains constant. So the answer to the problem is reversible constant pressure. So the heat is added in at reversible at constant pressure. The heat addition and heat removal at constant pressure, turbine and the pump work, they are at isentropic. So this is the answer. The next question: for a given set of operating pressure limits of a Rankine cycle, the highest efficiency occurs in saturated cycle, superheated cycle, reheat cycle, regenerative cycle. The efficiency of the Rankine cycle depends on mean temperature of heat addition. So actually the basic cycle is saturated cycle, improved cycle is superheated cycle, then the reheat and regenerative, these are all the advanced improvement in the cycle. So reheating is used in between the stages, in between the turbines, to add the heat energy and produce more work. And regeneration, we are taking the steam from the turbine for heating the water using the open feed water heater. So among the four options given here, the efficiency will be higher in the case of regenerative cycle. So the answer is regenerative cycle. Comparing with reheat cycle, regenerative cycle, the efficiency will be higher in the case of regenerative cycle. The next question from 1990 question paper: in a Rankine cycle, when superheated steam is used, the thermal efficiency is increasing, steam consumption decreases, steam dryness fraction after expansion increases, all the above. So when you admit the superheated steam, the steam with the higher temperature into the turbine, so the first three, they are true. Everything will happen. Thermal efficiency will increase, steam consumption will decrease, and the dryness fraction after expansion, that is turbine outlet, that also will increase. So the answer is all the above. The next question is from 1992 question paper: in a steam and other vapor power cycle, the process of removing non-condensable is called scavenging process, de-aeration process, exhaust process, condensation process. Scavenging process, exhaust process, they are connected with the IC engine, so no way connected with the Rankine cycle. De-aeration and condensation, they are connected with the Rankine cycle. But condensation, so the removing condensable, so the non-condensable that is occurring inside the condenser. So the non-condensable means air or any ideal gas, particularly air. So in a the condenser is always operating at lower pressure, lower than the atmospheric pressure. There is every possibility for the atmospheric air leaking into the condenser, because the atmosphere, the condenser is operating on the vacuum pressure. So often we have to remove the air entering into the condenser. The air is non-condensable gas. So the removal of non-condensable gas, that is called as deaeration. The process is called as deaeration. Removal of air from the condenser, that is what deaeration process. The next question from 1993 question paper, in adiabatic flow with the friction, the stagnation temperature along the steam line, whether this is increases or remains constant. Stagnation temperature along the steam line in the adiabatic flow process with the friction. We write the equation for stagnation temperature. Stagnation temperature equal to static temperature T plus V square by 2 Cp. V square is the velocity. Cp is the specific heat which is constant for the gas, for the fluid. T is the static temperature. So the when there is friction, the temperature is increasing. Because of the friction, the temperature at the outlet is increasing. Static temperature is increasing. Velocity is marginally decreasing. But the cumulative effect, the stagnation temperature will increase. So the answer is increases. The next question from 2002 question paper, the efficiency of superheated Rankine cycle is higher than that of simple Rankine cycle because the enthalpy of the main steam is higher for the superheated cycle. The mean temperature of heat addition is higher for superheated cycle. The temperature of steam in the condenser is high. The quality of the steam in the condenser is low. So the efficiency, the parameter efficiency of Rankine cycle depends on, as I told already, it depends on the mean temperature of heat addition. So in the superheated cycle, comparing with the simple cycle, the mean temperature of heat addition is more. The main reason is the mean temperature of heat addition is higher for superheated cycle. That is why the efficiency of the superheated cycle is higher than the simple Rankine cycle. The next question from 1995 question paper, consider a Rankine cycle with a superheat. If the maximum pressure in the cycle is increased without changing the maximum temperature and minimum pressure, the drainage fraction of the steam after isentropic expansion will increase. So the conditions, look at the condition. Maximum pressure is increased without changing the maximum temperature and the minimum pressure. So the drainage fraction of the steam will increase after the isentropic expansion, whether this is true or false. The statement is false. So we will see how. So this is the Mollier chart. We have to represent the Rankine cycle. We take the temperature is constant 500 degrees Celsius and minimum pressure is constant 1 pressure. We take a value. Temperature is 500 degrees Celsius and pressure is 1 bar. Minimum pressure is 1 bar. And this is one expansion line. So in the turbine. So I take the pressure, say for example 50 bar. Pressure 50 bar and the temperature is 500 degrees Celsius and the minimum pressure is 1 bar. So look at the condition here. It is, this line is 1 bar. So this is 1 bar and here the pressure is 50 bar and the temperature is 500 degrees Celsius and this is the isentropic expansion. Now without changing these two parameters, we have to increase the pressure. So the next line with the same data, there is no change in the temperature, there is no change in the minimum pressure, but the pressure is increased now. So from 50 to 100, the pressure is increased. Now look at the drainage fraction. So drainage fraction, earlier case, the drainage fraction is between 0.9 and 0.95. But here the drainage fraction is between 0.85 and 0.9. So for the given condition, the drainage fraction is decreasing. Drainage fraction is decreased without changing the maximum temperature and minimum pressure. By changing, increasing the pressure, that will decrease the drainage fraction. But what is given in the problem, in the statement? The drainage fraction of the steam after isentropy expansion will increase. So, the statement is false. Next question from 2015 question paper. Which of the following statement is regarding Rankine cycle with the reheating is are true? So, the reheating will increase the average temperature of heat addition, reduction in thermal efficiency and drier steam at the turbine exhaust. So, there are three statements given. Increase in average temperature of heat addition, reduction in the thermal efficiency and drier steam at the turbine exhaust. So, there are four options. Only 1 and 2 are correct. Only 2 and 3 are correct. Only 1 and 3 are correct. 1, 2, 3 are correct. So, the correct answer is 2 and 3 are correct. So, there is slight marginal decrease in the efficiency in the reheating process. Remember, in reheating, the work output is increasing. The net work output is increasing. So, in proportion to that, there is increase in heat supply. So, there will be marginal decrease in the reheating cycle, efficiency of the reheating cycle. But the temperature at the outlet of the turbine, the exhaust will have better quality, improved quality. That is what drier steam at the turbine exhaust. So, the correct answer is B, option B, statement 2 and 3 are correct. The next question from 2003 question paper. In a Rankine cycle, regeneration results in higher efficiency. Regeneration results in higher efficiency because pressure inside the boiler increases. Heat added before steam enters the low pressure turbine, average temperature of heat addition in the boiler is increasing, total work delivered by the turbine increases. So, as we discussed earlier, two questions we discussed. So, in the Rankine cycle, the efficiency depends on the mean temperature of heat addition, and for the regeneration, the mean temperature of heat addition is more. So, the average temperature of heat addition in the boiler increases. That is the reason for higher efficiency in the regeneration cycle. Next question is from 2016 question paper. The incorrect statement about regeneration in a vapor power cycle is that it increases the irreversibility by addition the liquid with the higher energy content to the steam generator. Heat is exchanged between expanding fluid in the turbine and the compressed fluid before heat addition. The principle is similar to the principle of Stirling cycle. It is practically implemented by providing feed water heater. So, the three statements B, C, D are correct. The incorrect statement is 1. The increase in irreversibility by addition of liquid with the higher energy content to the steam generator. That is the incorrect statement. And next question from 2019 question paper. Which of the following modification the simple ideal Rankine cycle increases the thermal efficiency and reduces the moisture content of the steam at the turbine outlet? Increasing boiler pressure, increasing turbine inlet temperature, decreasing condenser pressure and decreasing boiler pressure. So, the increasing thermal efficiency as well as reducing moisture content in the steam turbine. The answer is increasing turbine inlet temperature. So, increasing turbine inlet temperature will reduce the moisture content in the turbine outlet as well as it will increase the thermal efficiency of the cycle. So, next question from 2014 question paper. In a power plant, water of density 1000 kilograms per meter cube is pumped from 80 kilopascal to 3 megapascal. The pump has an isentropic efficiency of 0.85. Assuming that the temperature of water remains the same, the specific work supplied to the pump in kilojoules per kilogram is 0.34 kilojoules per kg, 2.48 kilojoules per kg, 2.92 kilojoules per kg, and 3.43 kilojoules per kg. So, let us calculate the pump work. So, the specific volume of the water. So, density is given 1000. The specific volume is 1 by density, so 1 by 1000 equal to 0.001 meter cube per kilogram. the work input to the pump equal to isentropic work input to the pump equal to V specific volume into delta P. So specific volume is 0.001 into delta P pressure rise 3 megapascal to 80 kilopascal. So 3000 kilopascal minus 80 kilopascal, which is 2.92 kilojoules per kilogram. The actual work input, we are given pump efficiency. So actual work input equal to isentropic work divided by the efficiency of the pump. So 2.92 divided by 0.85 equal to 3.43 kilojoules per kilogram. So the answer is 3.43 kilojoules per kilogram. The next question is from 1997 question paper. Consider an actual regenerative cycle, Rankine cycle, with one open feed water heater. For each kg of steam entering the turbine, if m kg of steam with a specific enthalpy H1 is bled from the turbine and the specific enthalpy of liquid water entering the heater is H2, then H3 is the specific enthalpy of saturated liquid leaving the heater is equal to. There are four options, MH1 minus H2 minus H1, H1 minus M into H2 minus H3, H2 minus M into H2 minus H1, and MH2 minus H2 minus H1. So, this is the heater, open feed water heater. So, the bled steam is taken from the turbine, which is admitted here with the enthalpy H1, and MKG of the steam is admitted to the open feed water heater. And from the condenser, 1 minus m kg of water is entering the feed water heater with the enthalpy H2. So, enthalpy of water leaving here is H3. So, this is from the turbine, the bleed steam from the turbine. This is from the condenser, liquid from the condenser. And this is the hot liquid from the outlet of the open feed water heater. Now, we write the energy balance. Energy balance H3 equal to M into H1 plus 1 minus M into H2. So, MH1 plus H2 minus MH2. So, the answer is H2 minus M into H2 minus H1. Rearranging the terms, H3 equal to H2 minus M into H2 minus H1. The option C is correct answer. Next question is from 2004 question paper. It is a common data questions. So, the statement is given here. There will be two questions for the problem. So, there is a reheat cycle. Consider a steam power plant using a reheat cycle shown in the figure. Steam leaves the boiler and enters the turbine at 4 megapascal, 350 degrees Celsius, where H3 equal to 3095 kilojoules per kilogram. After expansion in the turbine to 400 kilopascal, where H4 equal to 2609 kilojoules per kilogram, the steam is reheated to 350 degrees Celsius, where H5 equal to 3170 kilojoules per kilogram, and then expanded to in a low pressure turbine to 10 kilopascal, where H6 equal to 2165 kilojoules per kilogram, and H1, the enthalpy at the outlet of the condenser, enthalpy of water is 29.3 kilojoules per kilogram, and it is the, so because the pump work is neglected, so H1 equal to H2. So, we write down the given data, H3 equal to 3095 kilojoules per kilogram, H4 equal to 2609 kilojoules per kilogram, H5 equal to 3170 kilojoules per kilogram, and H6 equal to 2165 kilojoules per kilogram. So, the layout of the reheat cycle and all the data given here are written here. All the enthalpy at different points are written here. Now, we calculate the turbine work. So, turbine work equal to H3 minus H4 in the high pressure turbine, minus H5 minus H6 in the low pressure turbine. So, substituting numerical values 3095 minus 2609 plus 3170 minus 2165 equal to 1491 kilojoules per kilogram. And we calculate the heat supplied QS equal to H3 minus H1 plus H5 minus H4. So, substituting all the numerical values 3095 minus 29.3 plus 3170 minus 2609 equal to 3626.7 kilojoules per kilogram. So, the efficiency of the cycle, turbine work divided by the heat supplied. So, because pump work is neglected, so 1491 divided by 3626.7 equal to 0.411, which is 41.1%. And the pump work is WP equal to H2 minus H1, which is V specific volume into P2 minus P1, 0.001. Into 4000 minus 100 minus 10 equal to 3.99 kilojoules per kilogram. So the specific volume of the water is taken as actually density is taken as 1000. So specific volume is 1 by density equal to 0.001. And the H2, the enthalpy at the exit of the pump H2 equal to 3.99 plus 29.3 equal to 33.29 kilojoules per kg. And you note down all the information, but the first question, the efficiency of the plant neglecting the pump work. So, efficiency what we calculate is 41.1%. Second, the enthalpy at the pump discharge H2 equal to, we calculate as 33.3 kilojoules per kg. So, these are all the two questions connected with the problem. Next question is from 2006 question paper. Determine the correctness or otherwise of the following assertion and reason. The assertion is, in a power plant working on Rankine cycle, the regenerative feed water heating improves the efficiency of the steam turbine. Reason, regenerative feed water heating raises the average temperature of heat addition in the Rankine cycle. So, the four different answers are both A and R true. Assertion and reasons are true and R is the correct reason for A. The second is both A and R true, but R is not the correct reason for A. Both A and R are false. Option D, A is false, but R is true. Now, look at the statement once again. Assertion is, in a power plant working on Rankine cycle, the regenerative feed water heating improves the efficiency of the steam turbine. The statement is true. So, when you want to improve the efficiency, we have to use the regeneration. Reason, the regenerative feed water heating raises the average temperature of heat addition of the Rankine cycle. That is also true. So, both A and R, they are true. The correct answer is A, option A. Both A and R are true and R is the correct reason for A. So, what is given the reason? It is true. It is the correct reason for the assertion A. The next question again from 2006 question paper, determine the correctness or otherwise of the following assertion and reason. The assertion is condenser is essentially equipment in a steam power plant. It is true. A steam power plant requires a condenser. Reason, for the same mass flow rate and the same pressure rise, the water pump requires substantially lesser power than the steam compressor. Water pump requires lesser power than the compressor. This statement is also true. Right, when you compare for the same pressure rise, when you compare the water pump and the steam compressor, the water pump will consume lesser power than the steam compressor because the steam compressor is handling the specific volume, handling the steam which has higher specific volume. Right, so that is the answer. That is also true, but for A, the reason is not correct. A, independently, A is true, R is also true, assertion is true, reason is also true. But the reason given is not correct reason for the assertion A. So, the option is both A and R are true, but R is not the correct reason for A. That is the correct answer, option B. Next question is from 2007 question paper. Which of the combination of the following statements is correct? Incorporation of reheater in a steam power plant. There are four statements given. P, always increases the thermal efficiency of the plant. Q, always increases the drainage fraction of the steam at the condenser inlet. R, always increases the mean temperature of heat addition. And S, always increases specific work output. So, reheater in the steam power plant. The answers are, always increases the drainage fraction of the steam at the condenser inlet. And always increases the specific work output. So, reheater will improve the specific work output. As I told already, reheating will increase the specific power output, but there will be marginal decrease in the efficiency of the plant. And this Q statement is also correct. And the answer is B. Q and S are correct statements given in the problem. It is given in the question. The next question is from 2008 question paper. A thermal power plant operates on a regenerative cycle with a single feed water heater as shown in the figure. For the state point shown, the specific enthalpy H1 equal to 2800 kJ per kilogram, H2 equal to 200 kJ per kilogram. The bleed to the feed water heater is 20% of the boiler steam generation rate. The specific enthalpy at the state 3 is, there are 4 options: 720 kilojoules per kilogram, 2280 kilojoules per kilogram, 1500 kilojoules per kilogram, and 3000 kilojoules per kilogram. So the answer is 720 kilojoules per kilogram. So the answer is 720, H3 equal to 720 kilojoules per kilogram. So we will see how in the next slide. So this is the layout of the steam power plant. We are given H1 equal to 2800 kilojoules per kilogram and H2 equal to 200 kilojoules per kilogram. We write the energy balance for the open feed water heater. So H3 equal to H1 plus H2. So H1 is 0.2 times of H1, and H2, the enthalpy here, it is 0.8 times of H2. So 20% steam is taken for open feed water heater. The remaining 80% flowing to the rest of the circuit and enters the open feed water heater. So 0.2 into H1 plus 0.8 into H2. So substitute numerical value is 0.2 into 2800 plus 0.8 into 200 equal to 720 kilojoules per kilogram. So the H3 equal to 720 kilojoules per kilogram. That is the answer we selected. So we stop here. So thank you for watching. And you can please post your comments on the comments box. So you can subscribe the channel for updated videos. And you can write to me, to my mail ID or WhatsApp number, for any clarification on the subject. So we will meet again with additional problems from the Rankine cycle from the gate question paper in the next video.